In this video, I want to share with you a very simple t-shirt design technique. I'm calling it the circle technique. You'll see it all over the place. You'll see it in t-shirt shops, in Target, Walmart, on Redbubble, on TeePublic, on Merch by Amazon. A lot of these places have t-shirts designed like this, and that's because it's a very simple one to do. I'll show you how to do it in Affinity Designer, but you can follow along in any app that you choose. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005, and I want to help you to learn how to create a good t-shirt design. I know a lot of you have started selling t-shirts online, but have no clue on how to design a t-shirt. You want to get into the business, but have never designed a t-shirt before. This is for you. Also, those that have designed t-shirts before can still learn something on this. I'm going to do this in Affinity Designer and tell you the do's and don'ts on when to use this circle technique. You don't want to use it on every single design that you have. You want to space it out. I've used it before. I'm going to show you examples of other people using it on Merch by Amazon and Redbubble and TeePublic and things like that. You'll see the slight difference and you'll see how it works. So I'm going to show you how to do this in Affinity Designer. You can follow along on any app you have. You could do this in Canva or Illustrator or whatever app you have available that you like to be using. I'm sure all of those can do it. It's gonna be very simple to do. I'm just gonna show you some of the techniques that I do in Affinity Designer and follow along. So let's get into Affinity Designer right now. So here we are in Affinity Designer. Before I start showing you how to do it, let me show you some examples of what I've seen on Merch by Amazon, on Redbubble, and on TeePublic. And you can see this as well in different stores. You'll see it. And this is what I'm talking about. You have a design in the middle, kind of in a circle. Sometimes they have a little literal circle here, circle shape, but sometimes it just fills that shape and the text is around it. So you don't always have to put a circle in there. This one doesn't. But you have text on the top, kind of in an arc pattern, like around a circle. Text on the bottom in an arc pattern, kind of the whole thing being a circle, right? And a graphic in the middle. Sometimes the graphic in the middle is actually text. So think of this as a graphic in a circle. So you got text on the top, text on the bottom, a graphic in the middle. Sometimes the graphic has text, like I said. Sometimes the graphic breaks the circle. You can see right here, this one's breaking the circle, which is really nice. Sometimes there's no circle. Sometimes there's like a X in the middle, you know, that fills the circle. Sometimes it's a vintage sunset. Sometimes the circle is actually the thing around it, around the graphics, and the text is in the circle. So lots of different ways to do this. One thing to note though, is that it's not a lot of text. So you can see this one has 1, 2, 3, 4 words. This one has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 words, 4 to 6 words probably. This one has 3. So somewhere in that range, right? Not a lot of words. So keep that in mind when doing it. The fonts can be whatever kind of font you want. You're gonna want wider fonts for shorter words and thinner fonts or more condensed fonts for longer words or if you have more words. So as you can see, this one has 3 on the top, so it's very condensed. This one only has 2, so you can see it's a very wide. So think of that when you're picking your fonts. And other than that, color and whatever, you can see it works on white, it works on black, and anything. So let's make a template first. Let's grab this artboard. I'm gonna hold down Option and drag. I've already made it 4500 by 5400. You can see here. If yours isn't, do it in here. I'm just in the Transform palette, 4500, 5400. And you can make as many artboards as you want. So you can just do this, hold down Option, click, and shift, click on artboard and drag it. So I'm gonna take these out here just so we can use this as the artboard. And we're gonna start with a circle. So just go to here, circle, ellipse tool, hold down shift to make sure that it's a circle, and we'll just do it right there. Okay, and you should have guides turned on so it can tell you the center of it. If not, you know, you can click on one of these and then click center. All right, and the circle can be any color. We're not necessarily gonna use that circle. It's just there to hold the shape. So in your layers palette, you should have your artboard right here with your circle. I'm gonna hit Command J like that. So you'll see a second ellipse after hitting Command J. It's just a copy. I'm gonna go to my text right here, artistic text tool, and click on here. Remember, when it changes to that T right there with the squiggly line, click on it, and then just type word one, word two. We're gonna just use this as placeholder. So word, W-O-R-D, I wanna make sure that I can see it. Let's make it black. You can do whatever color, but this is just placeholders, right? Word one, word two. We're not putting in the words yet. We're just using this as a template. Move these triangles here and here. Where's the other one? There, and then center this. So double click on it. You can see right here, we're doing this center aligned, right? Center aligned. And let's move it up a little bit. So you move the baseline just so it doesn't touch the circle. So you can go up or down. So this is down, this is up, whatever you want. I'm gonna do 28. It doesn't really matter. It just, you don't want it to touch the circle, that's all. All right, and the next one you wanna do is you copy this now, now that you have word one, word two. Let's do J again. And this time, let's go to the text, but let's move these triangles so it's all the way on the other side here, like that. And you'll see yours do word one, word two on the bottom, but that's upside down. We don't want it to read upside down. We want it right side up. So double click on this, move this right here. This right here, it will reverse the text path. So click on it. You can see now it's the right way, but we're gonna have to move the baseline. So let's move the baseline and you can kind of eyeball it like that, right? So let's do this word three and four. Again, it can be whatever you want. All right, so this you're gonna save as a template. If you wanna use this again, you're gonna just be able to type your words here. You can use whatever font you want. I'm just using, in this example, I'll probably change it, but this is Nexa Rust Sans right now. All right, so now we have to find a graphic. So let's go to the internet. You can use Vexels, you can use Canva. I'm gonna use Vecteezy. Just find a quick graphic that we can use that we're gonna put in this circle to give ourselves something to talk about with these words, right? We can't put words without having something in the circle first. Let's go find a graphic to put in the circle. So here I am in Vecteezy right here, and I've already searched for mountain bike. You can do whatever you want. Do fishing, do gaming, do whatever it is, right? You can see there's so many different ones here, and of course you don't have to use Vecteezy as well. Just go over to your favorite place that you find graphics, or draw a graphic, that's fine too. But you can see some of these are already in circles, and of course you could use that real easy. I'm gonna do one that's not in a circle just so you can see the difference, but you could easily put these in a circle, right? Some of these are already in a circle. That's kind of a circle shape already. These are nice, nice circle. This one is a triangle. So let's try something different. It's not a circle, but I'm gonna try and put it in a circle. So I'm gonna click on this. I'm gonna download it here, and then we'll bring it into Affinity Designer. Nice, simple shape. Of course, you can use whatever you want. You can see lots of different places here that you can use for mountain biking or whatever your thing is. So it will still work. So let's get into Affinity Designer now, and I'll bring this in. All right, so you can see here, I brought the graphic in from Vecteezy. It isn't a circle, so let's make it fit a circle. If yours is already the circle, just make sure that it's the right size. So let's drag it in here. We're gonna wanna fill the space. I'm gonna remove this triangle. So because it's a vector from Vecteezy, I can take these out. Let's see. All right, so this could work here. Let's make sure we grab all of these. We don't need the lorem ipsum. There, let's get rid of that. All right, this is looking good here. So you see, we're just trying to fit it into that shape here. Now, it's missing something down here for a circle. So one thing you could do is you could actually leave the circle here for the circle shape, or you could have it kind of pop out of the circle. Let's try that. So we have this yellow circle. Let's hold down shift to make sure that it's still a perfect circle, and we can move it around here. You can see now I'm gonna take this and kind of make it break it. Break the sides here. This is breaking the side here. Another thing you could do is actually draw a circle. So let's do that. Let's try and draw, you know, just to kind of connect it. So I'm going to group all of these here. And I'll turn off the yellow circle here. Hey, that's looking good, right? It's kind of in the circle. So the next thing we're going to need to do is put some words. So of course, you're going to have to do some research on this, but find the right words to put in your t-shirt. You're going to do research and find out. I'm just going to put in what I think here. I didn't do any research on here, but I'm going to just do four words. Cycling is my therapy. Let's do that. My therapy. Now you can see I could make this bigger because I want the text to go out to here, somewhere around here, because I want to make sure that it kind of goes around to give that effect, right? So let's go in here and make this bigger. I'm going to double click on here. It's 80 right now. Let's see what 120 looks like. Yeah, that's kind of where we want it. We don't want it to break the halfway mark, but we definitely want it to break kind of the 2 o'clock area. So just around here. Let's see if this one does the same. I'll do 120 as well. Yes. Now, if you feel like these are kind of getting too far out, you can go in here and bring the letters closer together. So hold down Option and your left arrow key, and you can see that. I'm bringing it a little closer right here. Again, just going in here and bringing it in just so the word's not too far. And you can do the opposite here if you want that further away. You can do that. Same here with my therapy. And you can just hold it down as well. I like to click, 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 but if you hold it down, it does the same thing. Hold down your left key, left arrow key and Option at the same time. All right. So after looking at it, you may want to fill in some space here. I think I could put something right here, and I'm going to put a heart here for, you know, I love bicycling. So not me personally, but this shirt, I don't mind bicycling, but I don't have a bicycle. So I'm going to put a heart here, and let's make sure that in color it's just black. And there, you see how that fills the space? That's looking good, right? Nice. So one thing I like to do is just maybe put some circles in here to fill in the space if you want. But you don't have to. Yeah, you could do something like that, or maybe just put it in the middle just to kind of connect it. Make sure these two are the same. Boom. All right, cycling is my therapy. The next thing you might want to do is make a white one and a black one. So this one's, once you're all done, convert this to all black. Just make sure everything's black here. Oh, except those lines. Make sure you, whoops, go back. So these lines that we drew, I'm going to convert them to expand stroke there. And that's only because I want to make sure that I can color everything at the same time. So once I expand stroke, now everything is a object, so I can come in here and just, you know, change the color on everything if I wanted to, make it all pink or black or whatever. That's good, like that. And let's go here for black. I'm gonna put it right in the center and then change my artboard to, you know, some other color. And then make this all white, like that. And that would work on a dark t-shirt. So now you have two. And that's how simple it is to do that technique. Of course, you can do it with other designs. You can see here, I'm not following exactly this. I could have put a circle behind it. I could have left that circle right there. I could have had it breaking out of it and everything. So this is just a real simple way to have a quick t-shirt design that's gonna fit nicely in the shape. Now you can play around with how big the text is. You kind of want it to break this part right here. You can see here, same thing. So have fun with this. This is a very simple technique that you can use on anything. Play around with the different graphics and the different fonts and see what it feels like. Just real easy to have everything centered and nice. So hopefully this video was really helpful for you. So that is it for this video. Hopefully this video is super helpful for you. This is a very simple technique for t-shirt design, but as you play with it more and more and more, you'll get used to it and you'll be able to add your own different touches to it. Try different fonts, try different things in a circle, without the circle, different colors. It's very versatile and it's very simple to use as a beginner, but it's also something that someone that has designed t-shirts for a long time can use as well. It just always turns out really nice and kind of locks everything in. So you'll see it around everywhere now that you're looking for it on Redbubble, TeePublic, and even out in the wild. So look for those. I would actually take snapshots when you see those just so you can see how different people use it, how different artists use this style. So if this video is really helpful for you, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there. The question of the day for this video is, what subject will you use the circle technique on? Let me know that in the comments. We did one for mountain biking, but you can see that this will work for any topic out there, any niche out there. So let me know in the comment which one you're gonna try for. I'd love to hear it. Thanks again for watching. And if you wanna see more videos on how to design t-shirts, click on these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.